Hi, this is Juan with Cable Wholesale, welcoming you back to our Q&A series. I want to take a moment to introduce my co-host Miguel, another member of our tech team.
Hello, I'm happy to be here. Thanks for joining us today. We have a new topic that we have received many calls and emails about: property owners. The question is, how do I get an internet signal to a second building on my property when the distance is beyond the maximum 100 meter for copper networks?
So in our last video, we showed you how to get internet to a second building using copper Ethernet. Copper Ethernet can be used for distances up to 100 meters or about 328 feet. For today's solution, we're using fiber optic cabling. Cable Wholesale has all the parts you need to accomplish this. I'm still learning about the world of fiber myself, so we thought it'd be a great opportunity to cover this topic as a video. So let's go ahead and get started.
The solution we are discussing today is geared towards DIYers. We are assuming that the viewer doesn't have fiber optic termination equipment that can potentially cost thousands of dollars and might not want to hire a local installer.
So in this example, we'll be using our Ethernet to fiber media converters. Miguel, can you give a quick explanation as to what these do?
Sure. This media converter allows you to take a copper network signal and convert it into fiber. You can then use a second media converter to get back to the original copper network signal. We're basically using the fiber cable and the converter boxes as a form of an extender to get the internet signal to a second building. Starting in the building with internet, we will plug a Cat6 or other Ethernet cable into one of the available Ethernet ports on the router or switch. Then we can plug the other end of that same Cat6 cable into the Ethernet port of the first of the two media converters.
Here's where the fiber cable comes into play. One end connects to the fiber port on the media converter we just plugged in. The type of fiber cable and connectors will be determined by your media converters. Single mode or multi-mode LC, SC, or SD connectors can be used as long as the media converter supports that mode and connector. Whatever the distance, this fiber cable will be run to the next building.
In the building that needs internet, we'll have the second media converter waiting. Please be aware that both media converters require power. The final step is connecting another Cat6 cable from the media converter into your Ethernet switch. You now have internet in your workshop, man cave, she shed, whatever.
Cable Wholesale's custom department can also make custom length fiber to your specifications with the number of fibers, jacket type, mode, and connectors if needed. A pulling eye can also be added to help run the cable.
Running the cable between the building will require that you run the cable through conduit. Conduit will help protect the cable from being damaged if work is done on property in the future. The conduit can be laid on the ground if the terrain allows it. Conduit can also be buried in the ground.
It's always a good idea to test any setup before you run the cables. Now we're going to get out of the office for a bit to show you this setup in action. So we're using a 300 meter LC single mode cable. It's over 980 feet. We want to get far enough from the building so you know we are not using any Wi-Fi signal. We're going to be using extension cords to power the switches. So I want to thank everyone for joining us today. This has been Juan and Miguel with Cable Wholesale. Just a friendly reminder, our tech team is available by phone, live chat, and email from 8 a.m. Eastern to 5 p.m. Pacific, Monday through Friday. So please remember to like and subscribe so you don't miss any more of our upcoming videos about our fiber series.